The La Llorona Recreation Center lures in vacationers with an amazing ancient legend about a vengeful ghost. Thrill seekers from all over the country flock here to tickle their nerves. Karen Milligan, the head of the Recreation Center, will fill us in on the details.
This legend attracts visitors who are eager to soak up an atmosphere of the supernatural, but it's nothing but an advertising gimmick designed to lure in travelers. However, some people truly believe in this legend and even claim to have seen the ghost of a crying woman hovering over a nearby lake.
Help me!
Welcome to La Llorona. I hope you'll have a great time here. How can I help you? Oh, yes, ghost stories are indeed very popular in our area, but you have nothing to fear. It's just fiction. To check in at the recreation center, you'll need to pick up the keys to your bungalow at the reception desk.
To check in, please show me your passport and ticket. It can be either paper or electronic. Hello. Hello. To check in. You would want to visit our recreation center. All sorts of legends surround the place where people claim to have seen a ghost. It's on the other side of the river, so you'll need to take a boat to get there. You'll find the keys to the boat in your bungalow. You should also consider paying a visit to our Museum of Antiques. It has as many historical relics that have been found in the local area. You've made the right decision. I'm sure you'll have a great time there.
Welcome to our Museum of Antiques. Here you can soak up the rich history of this area.
This mirror is the most peculiar artifact stored in our museum. It was cherished by one of the mistresses of the old castle nearby. One day, she disappeared without a trace. I suggest you study this exhibit first.
Hello, my name is Jillian. I'm a newcomer here too. I realize you've only just arrived, so I've decided to get to know you. In fact, I think I recognize you. You're that famous writer. I'm a historian. I came here to find out more about the local legend. I guess that's what brought you here too. Actually, I'm on my way there right now. Feel free to join me. I can meet you on the beach if you like.
Sophie, one of the Las Lloronas of this island. I once lived in a castle nearby. This old mirror was my favorite. I often sat at the table in front of it to admire my own beauty. My husband, the king, loved me until a peasant girl came to our castle one day. She gave us a basket of peaches. After eating them, the king became obsessed with the girl. I trudged through the trees until I found her hut. I realized the girl was actually a witch who had poisoned my husband to make him fall for her. She poured acid into my face. Disfigured, but the king didn't recognize me, so the guards threw me out. I stumbled onto a lake and met a ghost who drowned me. Now, I'm trapped in my mirror.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot for your help. The ghost described in the legend is real. According to the old tale, a ghost appears on the riverbank on the seventh day of each month when twilight falls. Unhappy married women who couldn't be with their beloved lived their lives in constant misery and turned into Las Lloronas after death. Those ghosts sought out women whose struggles mirrored the ones they had dealt with in their own lives. And then, once they had found them, they drove them insane and drowned them in a nearby lake. An accident occurred in this area not so long ago. A woman named Lucy Miller vanished without a trace after taking a stroll by that lake. Lucy's husband, Greg, is still living in their recreation center, hoping to find his wife one day. His bungalow is located on the opposite bank of the lake, in an isolated area of the campsite. I'm actually not feeling too well. I think I'd rather go home. Please take my shawl. It might come in handy to you.
I'm all ears, officer. No, I haven't been able to find Lucy yet. Yes, I'm willing to continue living in the recreation center until we at least discover some evidence or some information about her whereabouts. You have a nice day, too. As soon as it's over, I'll need to destroy all the evidence left on my laptop. My plan has almost come to fruition. I made everyone blame that stupid urban legend for what happened. So many of them fell for it. Poor Lucy. I never meant to kill you. You always wanted more, and I couldn't satisfy your insatiable hunger. Yet, I didn't want to let you go. Were you planning to expose me? Your luck has run out. I'll get rid of you right in this basement, where no one will hear your cries for help.
Hello, it's me, Lucy. I've been watching you this whole time. I called you here because I knew you'd be able to help me. I can't appear in the world of the living through my own will alone. Greg killed me right after I told him I was leaving him. The injustice of him getting away with my murder is what trapped my soul in the world of the living. Greg stores his video equipment right here, in this basement. If you can record him confessing to my murder, you'll be able to prove his guilt to the police. I'll keep Greg unconscious until you finish installing the cameras.
The one guilty of my murder!
I'm so sorry, Lucy. I never meant to kill you. I loved you so madly that I couldn't stand the mere thought of you leaving me. It was a heinous crime of passion. I still love you just the same.
You are a real monster. I should have dumped you long ago. Call the police right now! I won't be able to hold Greg back for long!
I will make you pay for exposing me. Your days are numbered. Mark my word.
Thank you so much for your help. Now my soul is free at last.